In a world of big thinking, SpaceX's CEO, Elon Musk, thinks bigger than most. Seemingly single-handedly, Musk first pioneered and then advanced the acceptance of electric cars as mass-market vehicles, solar power as an alternative to oil, and the possibility that Mars could be colonized. But as revolutionary as all those ideas may sound, it's Elon Musk's plans for his space company, SpaceX, that could be the real earthshaker. Elon Musk's SpaceX has made major headway towards making space travel more accessible and efficient, thanks to reusable rockets. But until now, its focus has been on unmanned flights. Then, last month, Musk said the company was planning for a launch manned flight sometime in quarter two of the year. Now we have our clearest indication of when that date may be. In January, SpaceX completed Crew Dragon's in-flight launch escape test, which proved that the capsule can break away from the Falcon 9 rocket and splash down in the Atlantic if necessary during the launch. SpaceX has also successfully completed a round of engine tests without any explosions. After a successful in-flight abort IFA test in January, it had basically crossed off all the major milestones needed before flying people. First on a demonstration mission referred to as Demo 2 by SpaceX and its commercial crew partner, NASA. Elon Musk said he expected the SpaceX Crew Dragon to launch with astronauts on board sometime between April and June. Now Ars Technica's senior space editor, Eric Berger, said Monday on Twitter that the working date for SpaceX's Demo 2 mission is May 7th. Before marking your calendar with ink, however, Berger further notes that the launch date is fluid and could be moved up into late April or pushed back later into May, depending on issues not related to hardware. In this video, Engineering Today will discuss SpaceX's first-ever astronaut mission that could take off as soon as May, and SpaceX Starship production, which is well underway inside the new Texas facility. Let's get into details. Working date for SpaceX's Demo 2 launch is May 7, Eric Berger tweeted. Dragon is in good shape, launch date is fluid, and mission may move into late April or push later into May, depending on a number of variables, not hardware related. No final decision yet on duration. At this point, it seems things are going well for SpaceX and Crew Dragon. It makes sense that following the successful abort test and Musk's previous estimate, SpaceX Crew Dragon might be ready to launch on May 7th. We knew before today that SpaceX was getting very close to be mission ready in terms of its spacecraft. The Government Accountability Office released a report last week detailing progress on the Commercial Crew Program and noted that the SpaceX Crew Dragon capsule that will be used to fly astronauts for Demo 2 was on track to be completed 3 months earlier than was expected based on the most recent timelines. NASA's Commercial Crew Program Manager said that the in-flight abort test was our last open milestone before sending astronauts to the International Space Station. Demo 2 will be the second demonstration mission of Crew Dragon, following a Demo 1 uncrewed mission that flew in March of last year. That mission saw the SpaceX spacecraft fly to the International Space Station, ISS, dock with the orbital lab, undock, and return safely to Earth with a controlled landing, all using automated processes and without anyone on board. The Demo 2 mission will fly two crew, Doug Hurley and Bob Behnken, both NASA astronauts who will be completing their third spaceflight during the mission. Bob and Doug will at least fly aboard SpaceX Crew Dragon to the ISS, replicating the Demo 1 mission, but with a crew on board. Bob Behnken and Doug Hurley have been working closely with SpaceX since 2015, advising the company on the spaceship's development and training to fly it to the space station. Bob and I were lucky enough to be selected together, Hurley told in last September. As we get closer to launch, things in the last year have actually been pretty hectic. We've been spending increasing amounts of time in California because that's where most of the work is being done for Dragon. Behnken and Hurley's preparation so far has involved intensive training exercises, dress rehearsals, and dry runs of launch day procedures. But NASA has not yet decided how long the two astronauts will stay on the space station. NASA Administrator Jim Bridenstine recently shared that it would be looking into the possibility of extending the duration of the mission, which had been planned for 2 weeks, to allow it to actually rotate the crew of the ISS, just like what currently happens with Soyuz astronaut flights. If Behnken and Hurley get an extended mission, they'll have to go through additional training. But SpaceX has almost nothing but paperwork ahead of its first astronaut launch, NASA says. Even though it sounds mundane, there's a load of paper that has to be verified and signed off and checked to make sure we've got everything closed out. Doug Lavero, NASA's Associate Administrator for Human Spaceflight, told in a statement. He added, "It's probably one of the longest things in the tent to go ahead and do. It's underappreciated but critically important. You've got to make sure you've done everything you need to do along the way." As SpaceX works to get its Crew Dragon operational, the company is working to reach a similar milestone in a test of its other craft, SpaceX Starship. The company hopes to fly its Starship rocket 12 miles into the air and then land it back on the ground upright. The test, which the company filed a permit with the FCC for, could take place as soon as mid-March. In the meantime, SpaceX CEO Elon Musk has offered a new glimpse inside the company's rapidly expanding South Texas SpaceX Starship factory, revealing the beginnings of the next-generation rocket's first true assembly line and a wealth of Starship spacecraft hardware. Barely 9 months after Starhopper's first static fire test, SpaceX is working around the clock to erect a full-scale rocket factory and build what could become the first orbital-class Starships. On February 9th, Elon Musk offered the best glimpse yet of the incredible progress SpaceX has made in a matter of weeks. Barely a month ago, the rocket hardware didn't exist. Well, the giant Tesla-inspired tent containing those Starship parts was a half-finished skeleton. Now Elon Musk says that SpaceX has effectively completed three of the hardest parts of its first upgraded Starship prototype, SN01. Well, an additional two of three of those parts, known as propellant tank domes, are already in work for a second Starship, SN02. Outside of the sprung structure tent shown in Musk's February 9th photo, SpaceX contractors appear to be just days away from completing the shell of a second, identical tent, ultimately doubling the space available for enclosed manufacturing operations. At the same time as both Starship hardware and production facilities are rapidly coming together. SpaceX Crew Dragon spaceship was developed as part of NASA's Commercial Crew Program, which asked private companies to design and build new astronaut-ready spacecraft. Boeing and SpaceX came out on top in the competition, and the two companies are now racing to launch their first astronauts into space. But SpaceX's crewed launch will almost certainly mark the first human flight of any commercial spacecraft, since Boeing is facing delays and an internal safety review following a series of software errors found during a test flight. The SpaceX Crew Dragon capsule has gone through ups and downs throughout the past several years. In April of last year, an explosion engulfed the empty capsule in fire and smoke. The incident was set off by a leaking component and completely destroyed the capsule, a glitch that has contributed to SpaceX's delayed timeline for Crew Dragon, which it's developing for NASA. SpaceX, alongside NASA, the U.S. Air Force, and the National Transportation Safety Board, spent several months investigating the April incident before determining the root cause, which the company announced to reporters during a teleconference back in July, that a leaky valve had caused some of the propellant from the engines to cross over into another system, sparking a chain reaction that destroyed the capsule. SpaceX assured the public that it would redesign the system and replace the valves. Going forward, the company would replace the valves with burst disks. As always with space, expect some movement in that target date, but we're getting close enough now that the general ballpark should be a pretty accurate reflection of when things go down, barring any major issues between now and then. Once the capsule will be cleared for launching astronauts, but also eventually clear the way for civilian space tourism. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.